clock synchronization that happens in the network. FlexRay has unique ability to synchronize nodes on the network without any external synchronization clock signal. To do so, it uses two special types of frame, startup frame and sync frame. In the last video, we had looked into different parts of communication cycle, namely static segment, dynamic segment, symbol window, network idle time. In this video, we will look a bit deeper into each of those parts. Before that, let's understand the logic behind synchronization of these parts in the network. The smallest practical unit of time on FlexRay network is a MacroTick. FlexRay has FlexRay controller actively synchronizing themselves and adjusting their local clock so that the macro ticks occur at the same point in time on every node across the network. Macro ticks are often 1 microsecond long. Synchronization of macro tick is essential so that the data that realizes on the network is also synchronized. So with this understanding, let's look into each segment. Static segment. Static segment is a segment dedicated for scheduling a set of time-triggered frames. The segment is broken up into slots, each slot containing a reserved frame of data for each ECU. Hence, when each slot occurs in time, the reserved ECU has the opportunity to transmit its data into that slot. If in case ECU misses the slot, then it has to wait for the next cycle to transmit the data in that slot. Since the exact point in time is known in the cycle, the data is deterministic and each ECU knows exactly how old the data is in the network. For example, ECU 1, 2 and 3 have reserved their slot in static segment. So in case if any ECU goes offline, then the slot will still be reserved without any data being transmitted in the slot. Let's look into dynamic segment now. Most embedded networks have a small number of high-speed messages and a large number of low-speed, less critical messages. Hence, to accommodate a wide variety of data without slowing down the FlexRay cycle with an extensive number of static slots, the dynamic segment is introduced. Since dynamic segment is of fixed length, there is a limit on amount of data that can be placed in the segment per cycle. To prioritize the data transmission in dynamic segment, mini slots are pre-assigned to each frame of data in dynamic segment. This mini slot is typically a macro tick in size, and the higher priority data receives a mini slot closer to the beginning of the dynamic frame. Once a mini slot occurs, an ECU has a brief opportunity to broadcast its frame. If it doesn't broadcast, it loses this spot in the dynamic frame and the next mini slot assigned to other ECUs occur. This process moves down the mini slot until a ECU elects to broadcast the data. As the data is broadcast, future mini slots must wait until the ECU completes its data broadcasting. If the dynamic frame window ends in the cycle, then the low priority mini slots must wait until the next cycle for another opportunity to broadcast the message. Network might come across scenario where ECU 2 and 3 are using their first 2 mini slots, leaving no time for ECU 1 to broadcast. ECU 1 must wait for the next cycle to broadcast here. Now that we have covered dynamic and static segments, let's look into the frame associated with each of these segments. Frame used in these segments have three sections: header, payload, and tailor. Header section. Header is 5 bytes, that's 40 bits long, and includes the following fields: status bits of 5 bits, frame ID of 11 bits, payload length of 7 bits, header CRC of 11 bits, and at last, cycle count of 6 bits. Status bit is used to specify a message more precisely. Frame ID is used to identify a message corresponding to a slot. All IDs may be used except for 0. Payload length is used to identify the payload size. Header CRC is used to detect error during transfer of all the above data. And cycle count contains value of the counter that increments with each communication cycle. Payload. Payload contains data to be transferred by the current frame. The payload length should be the same for all frames sent in static segment. The length of the FlexRay payload or data frame is up to 127 words or 254 bytes, which is over 30 times greater compared to CAN. Trailer. The trailer contains 3 8-bit CRC to detect errors in the transfer of data frame. Coming back to segments of communication cycle, let's look into the symbol window and network idle time. The symbol window is primarily used for maintenance and identification of special cycle such as cold start cycle. Most high-level applications do not interact with this symbol window. The network idle time is of a predefined known length by ECUs. The ECUs make use of this idle time to make adjustment for any drift that may have occurred during the previous cycle. Lastly, let's look into the clock synchronization that happens in the network. FlexRay has unique ability to synchronize nodes on the network without any external synchronization clock signal. To do so, it uses two special types of frame, startup frame and sync frame. FlexRay cluster starts by at least two different nodes sending startup frames. The action of starting up the FlexRay bus is known as cold start, and the nodes sending the startup frame are called cold start nodes. The startup frames are analogous to start trigger, which tells all the nodes on the network to start. Once the network is started, all the nodes must synchronize their internal oscillators to the network MacroTick. This is done by using two synchronization nodes which broadcast special sync frames when they are first turned on. Other nodes on the network wait for the sync frame to be broadcasted and measure the time between successive broadcasts in order to calibrate their internal clock to FlexRay time. Once the network is synchronized and online, the network idle time is measured and used to adjust the clock from cycle to cycle to maintain synchronization. So with this, we have covered the basic concepts of FlexRay protocol.